Hi, it's me, Stormy, and we're doing the Oya Inspired Goddess Bath today. So let's start off with the definition. So a spiritual bath, to put it in simple terms, is a form of cleansing negative energy, thus purifying both your body and your personal energy. So this is not an educational video about spiritual baths or Oya. I will cover those later. This is just showing you how I do an Oya Inspired Goddess Bath. But I do think it's important to kind of cover the basics a little bit for the newbies. And also I want to say Oya. So we're going to talk about a little bit about her. So Oya is an African goddess. She is very confident. She invokes change. The character Storm was inspired by this African goddess archetype. She is the protector of women and children. She is strong. She is no nonsense. When you feel weak, you feel like you can't go on, you need inner strength, this is just a really good bath. And also releasing stagnation. So let's just get started. We'll learn more about her later. So Spellbound was a really good wine that I actually liked a lot. I liked it so much, I actually went back to the store to grab it. I could not find it, but instead I did find a wine that I liked a lot called The Old Soul. Both are very delicious. I recommend both, and Oya does like wine, so of course I have to have some wine there. Now the cleanup. Okay, so personally, I like to have my house clean. So when you get out the bath, it is just, you feel good, your space is nice and cleansed, because you don't want to, you know, feel all good and refreshed just to sit down in a dirty home or a dirty room. So just kind of straighten up, nothing too serious, because you're going to have plenty of time to clean up the bathroom. Now the bathroom is a little bit more tedious because you're going to scrub it down, okay? You got to take everything out. And basically what you're doing is you're creating a sacred space, the bathroom. So because you're creating this sacred space, you're just going to kind of cleanse it out. Everything to the visible eye can go. Take out the trash, put up the hair stuff, you know, take everything out. Just take it all out, girl. And yeah. Now, this does seem kind of extra to a lot of people, possibly. Like, this is a lot of work just to take a bath. But if I will do anything for someone else, I'm definitely going to do it for me, too. And I'm just getting into the nooks and crannies and just giving the bathroom a good scrub down. You're going to wipe down the walls, clean the mirror, clean the toilet. You could do a nice light mop in there. Just whatever makes it as clean as possible. This is your sacred space. This is like your little mini temporary temple here. So you just want to make sure everything is good to go. Okay, so I got this bath bomb set randomly from Publix. It was really cool. It's like a chakra base kind of thing going on. And so the crown chakra is purple. I want to turn the water purple and have purple and white candles because Oya, she's attracted to purples and burgundies. I have some sage and juniper here. You can do any sage combination you like. This is some salt with peppercorn in it. You definitely want salt in a spiritual bath, and peppercorn is kind of like spicy, and I thought that really reminded me of Oya. So then I have these orchid petals here, really nice purple. They float on top of the water, so I'm so here for it. The speaker, it turned purple during the bath. I don't know how I got it to turn purple, but it did. It worked out very well. Florida water is also very, very, very good at spiritual cleansing, protection, and prosperity and luck. Just saying. Oya is definitely into blackberries and plums and stuff like that. My plum was a little too ripe. I think I waited a little too long to eat it, but you know, it was still good. Everything was fine. Now, this was the most underwhelming bath quote-unquote bomb I've ever seen. This is like a bath fizz. So I crumbled it up a little bit to get it to dissolve a little faster. Next time I'll just make sure I get a better bath bomb. So right now I'm just saging. Make sure you crack the window open. And now we're just gonna build the bath. So I'm putting the salt in there, and it almost feels like you're like seasoning your bath water. Got some Florida water, sprinkle that in there. I'm putting the flowers in there, and I did want to just toss them in because I didn't want them to be upside down. So yeah, just flipping over flowers. Alright, so Oya loves eggplant, and her number is 9, so I got an eggplant, and I cut it into 9 pieces. Do we see how that works now? Like, the more intentional you are, the more powerful the bath. Alright, now the bath. So here is the bath. So you can read, you can journal, you can just relax and not do anything. Me personally, I love to listen to music when I'm in the bath, because I feel like if I get the vibe, I can like be in the water and just really feel myself in the vibe. So I do have a playlist I kind of want to share with you guys about different songs that remind me of oil.
Now I make money move. Say I don't gotta dance, I make money move. If I see you now speak, that means
me.
That was just a few of the songs that remind me of her confidence and very empowering and just feeling good about yourself. That's what the bath is for. So here's some disclaimers. Number one, make sure you do your research. Like I said, this isn't an educational video more than me just showing you guys what an Oya inspired goddess bath might look like, but make sure that you do the research you need to make sure if this is even something you want to do. All right, time and cleanup. This is definitely something you have to take time out to do. This does require pre-planning as far as like getting things you want in your bath, and you have to clean up before, you have to clean up after. So just keep that in mind, that I would take the day off or at least have the night to myself before I try to do anything. Number three, respect. Anytime you approach anything spiritual or religious or anything like that, always put respect on its name. And this is not for everyone. Make sure that, you know, Oya is someone that, you know, you do resonate with, or a spiritual bath in general is something you resonate with. I am doing a goddess bath to be released every Monday in the month of March. So maybe Oshun is more for you, or Yamaya, or something like that. But either way, it's not for everybody, and that's okay, because everything's not meant to be for everybody. But if it is something you want to do, I hope this video did help. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe so that way you don't miss future goddess bath videos and other videos I like to post. Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe, comment, like, all that good stuff. Bye.